Namaste everybody. In this session, I'm going to be showing some basic Carnatic flute fingering. A Carnatic flute has 8 fingering holes and 1 blowing hole. Totally it has 9 holes, and it has a natural node on one of the sides. That's a unique special feature of a Carnatic flute. So there are no corks. It has a natural node on one of the sides, and the other side is open, and there are 8 fingering holes and 1 blowing hole. The main difference between a Carnatic flute and a Hindustani flute is the Hindustani flute has only 6 fingering holes and 1 blowing hole, but a Carnatic flute has 2 more extra holes, so 8 fingering holes and 1 blowing hole. So I'm going to show you this basic fingering for all this Sarigama Padanisa, all the 7 swaras. I'm going to show the swarasthanas now. Anybody who has a flute, who has an 8-hole flute, Carnatic flute, can learn the right way, the right fingering. Because I get a lot of emails and a lot of people call me for the right fingering. So I want to make this video so that it helps all of them. So the first easiest note to be produced on the flute is Gandharam, Ga. Ga is the most easily blowable, easily playable swarasthana. So Ga, the fingering for Ga is always the right way to hold a Carnatic flute is you have to put your thumb underneath. You don't talk. Usually Hindustani flute players, they always bring their thumb outside their fingering holes. But Carnatic flute, the right way to hold the Carnatic flute is to tilt little bit your left hand, tilt it little bit like this, and then the thumb has to come underneath like this. And then the last, very last hole, we don't use it right now. We can use it later for the lower Rishabham and to get the lower Ri. Chatushruti Rishabham, we use this. But for now, for the basic fingering, you don't need the last one. The last hole, we don't use it right now. So the pinky comes here, your little finger, and then you close like this. And then your thumb has to stay under this nicely. So your both thumb acts like a stand for the flute. So even if you open all your fingers, the flute can still stay in your hand. So this is the right way to hold a flute, Carnatic flute. And now I'm going to show you all the fingerings. So let me start with Ga, because Ga is the most easiest sound which can be produced on a flute. So the Ga, the fingering for Ga is just that little finger, the pinky finger here, and then all the holes open. This is Ga. So this is how it sounds. So you have to, the correct sitting posture is very, very important to produce the right sound. So you have to sit straight, your back has to be really straight, and you have to take a deep breath, fill up your lungs with a lot of air, nice, long, deep breath. You have to do the deep breathing. Then you have to breathe steadily so that the Ga is in tune, in Shruti. So this is the fingering for Ga. Then all you have to do is bring this forefinger of your left hand forefinger down. So that becomes Rishabham. Ri. So this is going to be Ri 2, Chatushruti Rishabham. Ri. This is the finger. Once again, you were having the little finger here for Ga, so you don't do anything with your right hand, everything stays the same. All you do is bring this small forefinger here on your left hand, so then it becomes Ri. Ri. So So ga was this, and then from ga to re, all you have to do is bring one finger down. Now for sa, you close two fingers. This is sa. First and second all closed, and the pinky closed. This is sa. Again, like I said, you have to breathe nicely, you have to inhale nicely, take a long breath, and then you have to breathe steadily, so that without spikes, without jerks, you have to breathe constantly, slowly, and then every swaram, every note, you take a fresh breath, and then fill up your lungs completely, then start to blow the next one. So you already know ga, this is ga, then this is re, and two fingers down, this is sa. So to begin with, always you practice this sa re ga ga re sa. This is the first lesson which I always teach. Ga, you try to master ga, blow nicely. So the blowing part also I have taught in other sessions, but I will just quickly talk about I'll quickly say that you have to stretch your lips nicely like this. Then take the blowing hole. So it has to sit straight nicely. It has to sit nicely here. So initially when you try to blow the flute for the first time, probably it's a good idea to hold the flute here, and then slightly press it inward so that it sits nicely. See, if it is loose, you won't get the sound. So see, the moment I press, you get the sound. So you can figure it out. When you practice a couple of times, you will realize what is the right way to do it. So this is ga, and then this is re, and this is sa. So ga re sa, sa re ga. This is very important thing to practice in the beginning. Then the tricky note comes, ma. So for ma, you have to close everything. 1, 2, 3, 4. All these fingers closed. Anyway, this we are not going to use. So this is open. And then you close this two fingers also. So for ma, ma, the first hole open and the last, very last hole open. So this is ma. So again, take a fresh deep breath and then do this ma. Then from ma to pa, it is very easy. Pa, you bring your forefinger here, and then lift these two fingers, the pinky and then the ring finger of your right hand. You have to lift that. So the first five holes closed. This is pa. This is the fingering for pa. From then on, it's very, very easy. All you have to do is lift this finger. This is da. Da, four fingers close. So 1, 2, 3, and then this one. So this is da. And then ni, you lift this, but again, you bring this. This is kind of balanced, this is the flute. So this pinky always gives a nice steady balance for the flute, so that the flute is not shaking, flute sits in the right place. So ni, this is the fingering for ni. From ni to sa, all you have to do is lift this. And it is the same fingering for both high and low sa. It's the same fingering. Two holes closed and this pinky down. So all you have to do is blow little harder, little more blow you have to give so that you get the higher sound. Nicely, you have to blow a little harder. So you can also try to blow a little less and blow a little more so that you get the gauge. You can gauge how much to blow for high sa. So that much difference is there. So once again, I want to quickly recap the fingerings. This is sa, and then from sa to re, all you have to do is lift this finger, middle finger. You lift. Then this is re. From re to ga, all you have to do is open this. This is ga. This is the fingering for ga. From ga to ma, you have to bring all these guys down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the first hole is open. And the very last hole, which we never used, this is open. So this is the fingering for ma. From ma to pa, all you have to do is bring this finger down and then take this up. Take these two fingers up. So this is pa. From pa to da, all you have to do is lift this finger. Da. From da to ni, you have to lift this. At the same time, bring your pinky down like this. This is ni. And from ni to sa, all you have to do is lift this up. So let me play this once. Then you will really know this and you will learn this very well. Once let me sing and show the finger. Sa. Re ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da. Now, this is Raga Harikambodhi. I always teach all my students, to begin with, I teach them in Harikambodhi. Traditional Carnatic music is always started in vocal music. It is started in Raga Mayamalagola. But Mayamalagola is a little tricky to play on the flute to begin with. So because you have to deal with half notes, Re and Ni are half notes you have to play. So initially, it is tough for any new student to play Mayamalagola on the flute. So this is the easiest way to begin with, to play. All the notes are all, you have to close completely and open completely. So it's very easy to learn to begin with. So this is Raga Harikambodhi, which is the 28th Melakarta. So you learn this fingering in this ragam. So Sa, Re, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni, Sa, Sa, Ni, Da, Pa, Ma, Ga, Ri, Sa. Let me play this once for you. Every time, like I said, you have to take a fresh breath and then blow it out completely. The seven notes, they are the saptaswaras, sa ri ga ma pa da ni, and these are the corresponding fingerings which I have taught. If you have any difficulty, you can always reach me You can call me or email me and I can help you out to get the right fingering. Thank you very much. Namaste, students.